I'm Jared Fawson, here for another episode of UEN PDTV. And today we're going to talk about templates. You know, I think one of the toughest things about getting started in Canvas is you just don't know where to start. There's so much to do, and it's really hard to know where to begin. And that's the nice thing about templates is all the design work has been done for you. And so all you have to do is add in your content. And that's the stuff that you already know and can bring immediately with you into the course. Instructure has just added a lot of new templates into Commons. And so what we're gonna look at today is how to find and add these templates into your course. And then on top of that, we're gonna talk about how to personalize, customize, and really fit these to your style and to what you already do well in your class. So let's get started.
All right, well, we're going to take a look at these templates and take a deep dive into them. But the first thing that I suggest doing is to create a template sandbox course. You might already have a practice or a sandbox course, but I suggest getting one just for templates because you'll want to customize and do some things in there before you transfer it into a class that you're currently working in. So from your dashboard page, if you have the option, you can just start a new course here. And that's where I made this template sandbox course. If you don't have the option to start a new course, I would talk to your technology specialist and have them add one for you. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to select the Commons button. This will take me into Commons. And then from here, what you're going to need to do is go into the filter. And in the filter, I'm going to select templates. And then I'm going to select UEN K-12. And once I do that, you can just click out of the box, it'll disappear. And you can see we've got 40 different templates that are in here. And they range, as you can see, from secondary, in unit form, in weekly form. And then we've got, I mean, there's quite a few secondary themed templates. Then we've got some elementary ones. And we've got some professional ones, a bunch more elementary ones down here. And like I said, there's 40 of them. And this is fantastic for you because all of these are going to have some great stuff in them that will benefit you. So I've already gone through and looked through a lot of these templates. So I'm going to open this one up, this Canvas template secondary unit. So the difference between this one and the weekly one is this is set up, the modules are by unit, and this one, the modules are by week. So you can decide what you want to do there. Now, my suggestion after you open this up in Commons is you can preview what's in here. And the first thing that I would do is come to this template image options, because this is really going to let you know the style that this course is in. And most of the templates that are in here have an icon pack that goes with them. And I really like this icon pack, and I can see myself using a lot of these icons for things that I do in Canvas. So I like the way that that's stylized. And then I've got some banner options. I don't necessarily love these banners, but I know that I can customize it, and I like the size that they have there. But I do like the buttons that they have. And the nice thing is you can change the text and you can change the image if you don't quite like what they have here. And then they've got a course card, and you know, that's okay, but I know I can change that. So that's the key thing. Do I like the design in this image option? So that's the first thing that I would do is look there. Then after I've done that, then you kind of want to dive in and see how this is set up. So I'm going to go to this one that says class overview, and you can see here's where they're using these icons right here. And what you would do is just change the text that's in here to the way that you want it. Oh, there's another one of those icons. And you can see that you can be really consistent throughout your course with the way this is set up. And I want to use the same size of font with my titles and so forth throughout here. And if I don't like that picture, I can always change that too. Then there's a place for about your teacher where I would just replace that with my picture. And then I've got about these resources. This is helpful course links. And the thing is, if I don't want to use this page, I don't have to. Like, I just wouldn't publish it. And then we hop into like a class discussion. So the nice thing with the templates is you can preview everything in here and see if you like it. If you think you're gonna like most of it, but maybe not everything, well, it's probably still good enough to download and import into your course, and then you can just customize it the way you want to. So that's what I'm gonna do. After deciding on this, I'm gonna hit import download, and then I'm gonna find my course. It's this template sandbox one. And then I'm going to import it into my course. This usually takes just a minute. But one other thing to point out is they have this template image options and customization links page. And the nice thing here is this will walk you through how to add the icons onto any page or anything that you're doing, how to change the banners. So if I don't like this locker image on the banner, and I'm probably not gonna use that, the nice thing is this will take me to a different page where I can change the image, but it'll be the right size for the banner. And same with the buttons. I can change the image on the button and even the text, but it'll be the right size. And so that's a really nice thing that they've added, are these customization pages, so that you know how to do that. Okay. Our course should be uploaded now. So I'm gonna go to my dashboard, and you can see that it is, because there's that locker picture. And now I've got this in my course, and it's telling me how to set this up. You can see where the buttons are right here. I really like the design of this. And then I can go and customize it now. And that's what we're gonna look at right now, is how to customize your course. So let's take a look at how I can customize this to be the way that I want to. So I'm going to go to the modules page, and I'm going to select this image options and customization links page. And from here, this is where I can decide, okay, do I like the banner? If I don't like the banner, what am I going to do about that? Do I like the buttons and so forth? So let's start with one of the buttons. Let's take this learning modules button. So if I don't like the text or I don't like the image on here, all I'm gonna do is from this page, and again, I'm on the image options and customization links page. That's the one you need to go to if you wanna make changes. I'm going to select learning modules, and it's gonna take me to a Google Draw page. It's gonna make a copy for me, and you'll see how easy it is to make changes now. So if I don't like the text, like let's say that I just wanted to say modules instead of learning modules, I can just delete them. If I don't like the image, all I have to do is click on the image, and then right here it says replace image. When I do that, I have some options. So if I already have a picture that I want to use, I can just upload that from my computer. And the nice thing is it'll size it to the button size that I want it to be. But let's say that I don't have that option. I can just search the web. And what Google search will do is, this is only gonna allow me to search for ones that are licensed for what we're doing. So I can't search for everything, which is okay. I'm just gonna look for copyrighted images. So I'm just gonna type books in here. We'll see what comes up and see if there's an image that I like. This one's pretty cool. I'm gonna select that one. And then it gives me options. Do you wanna replace it? I say yes. There we go. And now I've got this set up. Now, I probably would do a, probably wouldn't pick that picture, but for our purposes, that's gonna work. Now let's say that I don't really like where the text is at, and I wanna move the text. What I can do is select this background first, and I can move the background up to the top here, and then I can select the text as well and drag that up as well. So you can do a lot of customization as far as the image, as far as the text, as far as where the text goes. And you know what, if I didn't like the color scheme, I can select this and make it a different color. Maybe I want it to be a little more blue. Now that I see that, I don't want it to be that blue. So I'm gonna go green here, and I can put different colors on all the buttons. I can have them all be the same. But again, that's the piece that you can personalize and customize the way that you want to. So now that I've got this the way that I want to, and I'm ready to put it into my course, what I'm going to do is go to File, I'm going to go to Download, and then I'm going to download this as a PNG image. And then once I do that, I'll be able to easily add that into my course. So we downloaded this. And what we're going to do now is we're going to go to our course files and we're going to select template images, homepage images, and we're going to go to buttons. And when we do that, so these are the four that were there. Remember, we changed the learning module one. So what we're going to do now is we're going to add the new button that we just made. So I'm going to select upload. And here it is right here. We're gonna add this in. And if I want to change the name, which I probably do, instead of having it say copy, because we took the learning out, so we're just gonna call this modules. In fact, I'm gonna put modified, then I'll know what it is. So modified module. So now that's in there. So what I can do with this is go back to the homepage, and there's the one that we changed right there, that learning module. So I'm gonna go to edit, and I'm gonna select this. I'm just gonna delete it off of here. And then I'm gonna go to the rich content editor. I'm gonna select embed image. I'm going to go to canvas. And then again, we'll go to that course files and we'll go to where we put it. So we put it in the homepage images and buttons. And we call it modified modules. And I'm gonna hit update and there it is. So that's how easy it is to change one of the buttons. You know that we changed the text, we changed the image, we changed the color, we moved the text to the top. You could also change the font if you wanted to, but again, if you're going to do that, you're going to have to be consistent and make sure that you do that everywhere. And that's really the key thing, is any of these changes that you make, they need to be across the board and not just like a one-time thing. So now I've changed that and I could hit save, add it to my course, and that's how you change one of the buttons on there.
Well, thanks for joining us today. Here's a couple tips from what we discussed. Make sure to have a sandbox just for templates. Use the filter in Commons and select templates and UEN K-12 so you can find all the ones that are there. You can preview anything in the template before you download. I suggest checking out image options to see if you like the icon pack and design. Then you can look at how the rest of the course is set up. Use the image options and customization links page to change the banner, buttons, and course card. Once you've made changes, then you can upload your new image into the course files and add it into your course. When you've configured the template the way you want to, you're ready to import it into any of your courses. So good luck and happy templating.